And now another media commentary, the topic rattling the sabers at the Asian Security Summit. Good evening and welcome. Before we look in detail into how the USA is advancing in steps against China, let's pick up where we left off in our program from the 18th of June 2014, with the title Executions by the Media. Here we explained the exact correlations about why it is that China must be constantly under US criticism in the future. Do you remember?
When a global power like the USA wants to keep its position of power or go on extending its impact, what will they do? Right, they will look for the Achilles heel, that means for their greatest rival's weakest points, in order to, with the help of these weak points, already execute them in the media in advance. Today, everyone knows who the USA's greatest rivals are: Russia, Iran, and China.
Study this broadcast again so that you don't lose track of the logical sequence. Here is the prognosis for how this sequence will continue, as shown again in Swiss mass media SRF programming on the 31st of March. At the Asian Security Summit, U.S. Defense Minister Charles Timothy Hagel, alias Chuck Hagel, criticized China with these remarkable words: "China has been destabilizing for months a whole area of the world for selfish interests. Does the USA see itself in the mirror? Yes, something like this is plausible. Interesting, anyway, that of all people, the US defense minister voices such accusations. Has it not been verifiably the USA which for years destabilizes country after country? And in order to satisfy the seemingly insatiable hunger for oil, not only are they destabilizing one area of the world, but the whole world." Well, at least Chuck Hagel's comments at the Asian Security Summit show that the USA know very well that one must not destabilize other countries for egoistic interests. His next quote shows still more insight. I quote, "Instead of allowing territorial conflicts to be solved with international courts of arbitration, Beijing is putting its neighbors under pressure." Oh, are they really doing this? And if so, what is suddenly so extraordinary about this? This type of thing is done constantly by the US government. From Africa to Syria, the Ukraine, and now Russia. There they are themselves enough of an arbitrating court. And further, I quote, "But the USA will not let down China's threatened neighboring countries," assured Pentagon boss Hagel. Oh yes, now we remember again the sequence of events where we left off. China is in the way of the US government's global domination. How will they manage this, especially since they are soon out of money? This is how the Pentagon boss does it. He already called upon China's neighboring countries to work together to strengthen their position towards China. Especially, he greeted emphatically the more energetic foreign and security policy announced by Japan's head of government, Shinzo Abe. Then the US Minister of Defense complained about forced money saving in the US military budget and President Barack Obama's announcement to hold back with military operations. And like this, without even a dollar in the hand, already the biggest rival is surrounded. Aside from this, the defense minister could make known, for domestic record, his newest arguments for a campaign for an increase in armament funding. This scenario would bleed the American people still more and force them into still more poverty. Even though Hagel did not promise anything to China's neighbors, he did not fail to express his assurance in this one final point. I quote, "But in spite of all the challenges for the USA in the Middle East or because of Russia, we can and will continue to show our colors in Asia." So finally, we are left with the question, when will the USA show its colors in China? All of these events very strongly resemble the previous world wars. After all the nations were destabilized and agitated against each other, after all the nations had used up their ammunition on each other and lost their best men, then the USA showed their colors, took over, and went down in history as the winners. Yes, this is exactly the sequence of steps towards global dictatorship. to world domination. Think about this and inform those around you. Maybe we can still change something. Thanks for all the voices and counter voices. Let's bravely and soberly continue observing the further development. We wish you a good evening.